What is it? To put it politely, the Ford Mustang GT isn't the first car you'd choose to develop into a stripped-out, no-compromise track machine. For one thing, it's a sizable old bus. It's 30 centimeters longer than the Porsche 911, a rather more obvious candidate, and some 10 centimeters wider, and for another it weighs the better part of 1,800 kilograms. There wasn't a great deal Ford Performance could do about the Mustang's size, but to give the Shelby GT350R a fighting chance on track, it ditched the rear seats, the stereo, the navigation system and the air conditioning, although the latter three items can be added back and optionally. The wheels are exotic carbon fiber items, too, saving 6 kilograms at each corner. The total weight loss over the 5.0 GT is 60 kilograms, which is useful if not exactly transformative. The entire chassis has been overhauled with upgraded components and a much more track-focused setup, while a comprehensive aero package promises much more downforce than the regular car. Most unusually, though, the warbling V8 engine that powers the conventional Mustang has been ditched for a higher revving 5.2-liter flat-plane crank V8. That's something of a departure for an American muscle car. Flat-plane cranks and higher revving V8s have been the preserve of European sports cars until now. The new motor revs beyond 8,000 revolutions per minute, whereas the outgoing cross-plane V8 doesn't reach far beyond 6,500 revolutions per minute. The power and torque figures hint at a revvy V8 rather than a lazy, torque-rich bruiser, 2.526 bhp at 7,500 revolutions per minute and 429 pounds-foot at 4,750 revolutions per minute are not typical Mustang numbers. The soundtrack isn't typical Mustang either, the rumbling score replaced by highly strung snarls and barks.